Hi, I'm Mr. Beats. I'm one of the subject matter experts here at Chegg. And in this video, we are going to review the welfare created by perfectly competitive markets. Let's quickly review how to find a market equilibrium. A perfectly competitive market is an equilibrium when supply equals demand. It corresponds to the intersection of the supply and demand function, point E, on this graph. Therefore, P star and Q star are the equilibrium price and quantity in the stylized market represented by this graph. With this in mind, let's take a look at one of the most important properties of this market equilibrium, the ability to maximize social welfare. In this stylized market, we have two economic actors, the consumers and the producers of a generic good. Let's start by looking at the producers. How much benefit do they get from selling their product? Well, what they gain is equal to the amount the seller sold the good for minus how much it cost the seller to provide it. Once we sum what producers gain across all transactions, we get a producer surplus, which is seen by the blue shaded area on the graph. From the point of view of the consumers, instead the gain from trading is equal to the difference between the amount they are willing to pay for a good, represented by the demand function, and what they actually end up paying for it, the market price. If we sum consumer gains across all transactions, what we get then is a consumer surplus, represented by the orange area on this graph. When the supply and demand functions are linear, like in our example, you can compute the producer and consumer surplus by calculating the blue and orange triangles on the graph, respectively. Here you can see the formulas. The social surplus is the sum of the producer and consumer surplus. Once we have computed our consumer and producer surplus, we can see that there is something pretty special about this equilibrium point. It is the point at which the social surplus is as big as it can possibly get, given the supply and demand function. This is why perfectly competitive markets are seen as efficient. They maximize social welfare. We can easily see this in the graph. In fact, if the quantity exchanged is lower than the quantity equilibrium, say Q prime, then we would miss all the gains from trading the last few units of a product, with a decrease in the social surplus equal to the red shaded area. If the quantity exchanged is higher, say Q double prime, then for the last few units produced, the marginal cost of production would be too high than what the consumers are willing to pay, a negative surplus. The corresponding decrease to the social surplus is equal to the yellow shaded area. So that's a basic overview of the welfare effect of a perfectly competitive market. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.